is out, the generators are outside of homes all across Meadow Vista.
Yeah, that's a tough situation.
This is Sean Severinson's third PG&E shutoff just this month, so he has his routine down to a science.
This is my job in the morning. Wake up in the morning, come out, turn the generator on, take the ice out of the fridge.
But now he's dealing with concerns you can't prepare for. Burglars seeing outages as an opportunity.
I mean, anytime there's these kind of situations, there's going to be people trying to take advantage.
The Placer County Sheriff's Office is investigating a report of men knocking on a house without power, pretending to be with the sheriff's office. When the homeowner showed them she was there, they ran away. She thinks they were casing the house to try to steal.
Burglars are going to look for easy targets. That's houses without lighting, houses that are unoccupied, houses without alarms, anything that would attract or draw that type of activity where they're not going to be discovered.
Lieutenant Andrew Scott explains that unfortunately, all those features match areas going through shutoffs, but there are some ways to protect yourself.
If you have any doubt that the person is a PG&E worker or a law enforcement officer, call 911. We will respond and we can make sure that the person is who they say they are.
Also pointing out that law enforcement will not show up at your house out of uniform or in unmarked cars.
It's always a good idea when something unusual happens, especially like these power outages that we're suffering right now, that you just keep an eye out for your neighbor.
Advice Severinson takes to heart.
I'm mainly concerned for like the people who are retired. There's some people around here that live alone that are retired, and so we check on them.
And that was Jessica Mensch reporting.